I'm singing Desire by U2.
Wes's biggest challenge is to get his head around less is more. He tends to get out there and belt it right from, you know, go to woe, and it's sort of, it's relentless. Might be good to sing it quite close and kind of sexy rather than, because you're belting it out through the whole song, pull yourself right back.
Yeah, right, wow, cool.
They sort of said to me, make sure you get light and shade into your vocal technique. Sister,
you know, I want to see if he's got other tones in his voice other than just belting it out.
Yeah, I agree. And more dynamics, you know, rather than just singing the one thing all the way.
He's also seems really open to ideas and suggestions that we gave, so it's good. It's not like he's sort of a jaded guy that's been in a bunch of bands, and I think he's a really good performer.
It's a good thing, because he's chasing after Bono.
Back in 1989, U2 were all about cowboy hats, and they released a fantastic record called Rattle and Hum. From that record, this is Wes Carr, Desire!
Lover, I'm on the street. Gonna go with a bright light to the big city with a red guitar on fire. Desire, she's a candle burning in my room. I'm like a needle, needling a spoon over the counter.
You use the stage, you're not... Don't you like that leg-shaking thing? You know, you use the stage, you're not frightened. No, it's all good, darling. You use the stage, you're not frightened of it. You don't... I mean, it is almost an alter ego when you get up there on stage, you know? And you can just do and be... And you did and was and... It was incredible! Thank you.
Thank you. Did you catch it, Marsha?
Can I ask you, what's it like sitting on a judging panel next to your ex-mother-in-law? Is it a bit nerve-wracking?
Well, I must say I've never heard a speechless like that and trying to, like, not be able to say something.
No.
But it's pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. This is my favourite ex-son-in-law, by the way. So there you go.
The only one, I think.
Yeah, that's it.
Truly. Hi, Wes.
Hello.
How are you, mate? I bet you can't remember anything about that performance then.
No, I can't. I can't remember any of it.
Yeah.
Every time I get up here, it's a blur to me.
Yeah. Yeah, it was good. Like, you know, you use the stage, like, you know, we were talking about with all of you guys this week, and you're comfortable with it. You're the full package. I think that was a really good performance. Yeah. Probably the best tonight.
Thank you. Thank you.
I know we're not supposed to have favourites, but I'm pretty obviously you're my favourite. Because to me, when you're running around up there effortlessly singing that song and there's five or six cameramen racing around the stage trying to keep up to you, that is a rock and roll show, you know what I mean? I agree with Kirk, the best performance so far tonight. But, hey, that's what you seem to be serving up week after week, man. Nice.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
Okay. Don't try and steal my thunder, James Matheson. Get off the stage. Okay, look, Wes. Further, thank you. Wes, look, I said to you earlier in the competition that because you were so good week after week, your challenge will be plateauing, right? And I think tonight you've actually got that monkey off your back because you did come out, it wasn't try hard, it was just full of rock and roll abandon, and it's exactly what we want. We needed you to step up tonight. Best performance of the night. Well done.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
Well done, Wes. You must have been chomping at the bit when you found out we had Rock Night coming up.
Yeah, man. I just want to know, did Marsha catch my harmonica there? Really expensive.
Yep.
Yes.
Awesome. Bless. Yeah.
She's going in to get something special after the show.
She's quite sporty, Marsha. Now, if you desire to see Wes saved tomorrow night, then you've got to call 1902 555 555 66.